His kick comes off the back to Crompton right up from the back pocket. If Crompton goes, the Demons are back in the lead. And it's through the middle. Collingwood calls on its never-give-in spirit, but the Demons are equal to their challenge. 4 points behind, Collingwood throws everything into the final minute. Trying for a break on the wings, the Magpies are almost through, but Melbourne's strong and speedy defence holds firm, although stretched to the limit. And there's the siren. Melbourne wins 8-16-64 to Collingwood 8-12-60.
The 1970 VFL Grand Final had it all. In front of a record crowd of 121,696, football's greatest rivals, Carlton and Collingwood, played out a match for the ages. There would be the goal-kicking genius of Peter McKenna, whose 5 first-half goals enabled the Magpies to lead by 44 points at half-time. Carlton would respond through an unlikely hero in 19th man Ted Hopkins. His 4 goals helped the Blues to a famous and barnstorming victory by 10 points.
Jesse Lengo getting a huge round of applause as he comes around the boundary line, but back to the plate. Moore got high, tried for the screamer. It didn't work though. Anderson Grant, we're not in possession. He must get a free kick, surely. No. It's going Carlton's way and it will be taken by Francis. Francis up from the back pocket, goes for the long kick. Towards the centre wing position, Johnson was behind the pack. It's socketed away by Keogh. Down towards the half forward line, Harms tries to pick it up. Buckley gets it out to Harms now. He's pursued by Brewer, but he can't catch him. Harms fires at the goals, but he's off target. It's rolling towards the boundary line, and Harms almost makes ground. He tips it back to Sheldon, and it's a goal! Oh, what a goal! If you don't mind!
No doubt for 98.
Siren just about due to go. Peter Ball with a big punch out, picked up by Dacos now on the half forward flank. Freem chasing, but he'll have a shot for goal. In towards the square it goes. I don't think that was touched. In fact, it has gone through for 1 point. So, 33 and three-quarter minutes gone in the final quarter. Malthouse now from fullback. Upfield, taken by Mervyn Kane. Long kick by Kane. There's the siren. Richmond have won their first premiership since 1974.
Supported Peter.
At least. Phil Maven is at left half back flank.
David Parkin on the boundary there. He knows his side's going to win the premiership and he's out there to enjoy the celebration when the final siren goes. It must be getting pretty close. Stewart couldn't pick it up. It's finally knocked out by Bazusto. Out there towards McClure. He'll tap it off. But there's no one there for Carlton. It doesn't matter because the Magpies have lost this match for sure. Well, there's the siren and Carlton have won the 1981 Grand Final. The final scores. 12 goals. 10-12-72.
And a great
force now, they won't mind. Brown is there. Keating knocks it down near the line. It's over. Stop the clock. 29-40 gone. Brisbane by 9 points, hanging on grimly.
I think you look at the 1 point and you'd have to say Michael Lawson, centre-half back, when he put his body on the line, is a difference in this game.
From the throwing, Burns takes it but is brought down. Brisbane Lions there in numbers, but Collingwood steal it. Ben Johnson away. Is there time? Johnson to Davis. He marks 60 out. Most engrossing, captivating struggle you will ever see. Not once during the game did the margin reach double figures.
But the Lions have gone back to... to back-to-back, become the greatest side of the modern era. They are football's invincibles.
Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my share of bad kicks in my bed, but I've come through.
And I need to go home.
Side by side.